Welcome to the SOTI video series. My name is Richard Fitzsimmons.
And I am David Issa, both of us senior principal instructors here at SOTI. And what's in store for today, Richard?
Well, in this video, we're going to discuss the requirements and considerations for getting a modern Zebra printer enrolled into SOTI Connect. Just a call out for some of our previous videos. In video one of this SOTI Connect series, we looked through just generally how SOTI Connect works and its component communication, followed by an installation. And then we focused a little bit more on the third-party components that are required for devices such as Zebra devices and other devices that use the MQTT protocol to communicate. And that was the setup of our MQTT broker.
Now, it's very important to know that Zebra devices are a bit of a hybrid, because Zebra devices, depending on the operating system that are running, the Link OS operating system that they're on, they can support either SNMP or MQTT for the most modern and the more robust printers. So it's important to know which model you are dealing with, because whichever protocol you're going to choose depends on the type of printer, how modern it is, and what is the actual operating system that it has on it. So it's very important you know that, because when we say Zebra printer support, it could actually be MQTT or SNMP.
Yeah, and on that note, to check your particular devices, you can always go to SOTI Pulse, the certified device list, and if we go down to Zebra, we'll be able to see which particular models support MQTT, which we're particularly focused on today, and also which are supported using SNMP, which we'll be looking at in a further video. Now we can see the various different models. Let's pick one, for example, that uses MQTT and uses our MQTT broker. David, you mentioned Link OS. So, you know, where's Link OS referred to, and whatever elements of this are we going to have to keep in mind?
Absolutely. So if you open a Zebra printer and you go to the firmware version, you're going to see something that's like that collection of like three subset of numbers and letters, and they do translate into a version of LinkOS, which you can easily reference in this page over here. Now, what we're looking for is at least version 6.7 of LinkOS, and you want the advanced version of LinkOS 6.7, not just the basic. And also, we focus exclusively on printers that are not Bluetooth only for this type of communication, so they have to have a connectivity element to it. So you're definitely looking for 6.7 advanced, so then MQTT can be an element that you can configure in those printers, which is what we're going to be showing today.
That's it. Fantastic. So, you know, as well as this, we have an MQTT broker that's been set up previously. Our SOTI Connect protocol adapter is registered to that broker. So what do we need to give to the printer so it can go and talk to the broker and in turn SOTI Connect?
Now, it's very important to know that this is video four of the series, if you're following the MQTT series, that is going to be highlighting the different needs and requirements for the connection to happen. So if you saw our previous video, which if you haven't, please go for the previous three videos. You notice how we had to register the protocol adapter to the broker, and there were some pieces of information that we were going to, that we required in order to make this connection. Well, I didn't mention it in the previous video. That's the exact same information you're going to need to give to the printer, and that is the location of your broker, the port where the device is going to be able to access the connection in the broker, and finally that certificate that's needed in order for that device to be able to access the server certificate connection established through TLS.
Okay, so this starts to make a bit of sense in terms of what we're seeing on screen. So essentially, this is a combination of commands that would be sent to the device, the printer, in order for it to go and talk to the MQTT broker. And really, we can probably start breaking this down, because actually we've got the certificate being referred to, we've got the location of the broker. I can also see a little bit of information in terms of like a time reference as well. So is it possible we can just maybe go from the top and see what each element is doing?
Absolutely. But before we do that, let me introduce what you're looking at in here. Remember that we're actually dealing with Zebra printers, and for those that are veterans in Zebra printer, I probably don't even have to do any of this introduction. But for those that are relatively new, Zebra printer uses ZPL language as a way to configure the elements that the printer needs to be changed or needs to be adjusted. Therefore, what we're showing right here is an actual ZPL language representation of the commands that need to be shown or sent to the printer in order to configure the MQTT MQTT connection. Now, Zebra printers, generally speaking, support two MQTT connections simultaneously. In this case, we're going to be setting up the first one. So you can actually see that because number one is used everywhere where MQTT is referenced in these commands. And these are three main sections that you're going to be able to configure. Number one is the certificate. Number two is the timing on the device, because remember, certificates can be invalid if the time is not correct. And number three, the actual connection elements needed to reach the MQTT server from the perspective of the printer.
Oh, I see. So firstly, we're actually referring to a file name on the eDrive of the printer that's going to store the CA, our certificate. And I can see now we've got the actual certificate being referred to. And we've created a number of certificates, or referred to a number of certificates in our previous video. If I bring them up on screen here, which of these certificates are we referring to here?
Well, this is where the relevance of formatting comes in. Remember I mentioned about a portable type of certificate, something that's simplistic. Well, printers require that. And you remember how we took that SOTI Connect infrastructure certificate and we exported it into PEM, which is the exact same certificate we use in the registration. So that is the .PEM. Now, we have a text element that we need now to configure in ASCII characters. And this is where we now need to be able to insert the certificate in that format. And there's a secret with PEM certificates that is very applicable here. Richard, can you let us know on what exactly I'm talking about here?
Absolutely. So we have a PEM file, we can open it. Let's choose another app and we can actually open that this using Notepad, and we can see the contents of the certificate. And as you said, this is exactly the same certificate that was used when we registered our protocol adapter. It's still using that same public certificate, but we can just get it in this format and insert it into our list of ZPL commands, which are going to be passed to our Zebra printer.
And essentially what we're doing here is that same PEM file that we have, we're transferring into a .nrd format that is needed by Zebra printers, and that's the contents of the certificate, which essentially brings the root certificate into the device, which is requirement number one.
Okay, and underneath that, we can then see we've got some reference to NTP or time servers. Now, for those who were with us when we set up our MQTT certificates, we refer to a certificate validity on the server certificate from the MQTT broker. And this is where it comes back to it, because very often a printer that's out of the box, it may be showing a default time of several years ago. So we're really just making sure that the printer is being provided the current time. So when it communicates using the certificate to the MQTT broker, it's got the same timestamp and communication is allowed.
And the certificate doesn't get invalidated, because that's something you're going to experience if you don't do this step.
Okay, so that explains why we've got a time reference here. And then lastly, there we are. We've got our MQTT, we've got our server address. So again, which server is this?
So that's going to be the FQDN of the server that's hosting the broker. Remember, it's the same information that we delivered when we registered the protocol adapter with the broker. So if we have that information handy, all you have to do is making sure you put that FQDN in there and the right port. And at that point, with this combination of elements, you should be good to go. And I do believe we also can find this information in our documentation. Is that correct, Richard?
That is correct. And keep in mind, in our setup, we've installed the MQTT broker and the SOTI Connect components all on the same machine, but of course the broker could be hosted separately if that is a requirement. Thank you for joining us in this video where we've seen the requirements and considerations for enrolling a modern Zebra printer into SOTI Connect. Join us for the next video in the series where we'll work through these steps practically.
For further tutorials, please visit us and subscribe to the SOTI YouTube channel, and for more information about the SOTI One platform, visit us at SOTI.net.